हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ द प्रोफेसर राजकुमार लांडगे फ्रॉम NB नोले सिंहगढ़ कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग सोलापुर। आई एम वर्किंग एज ए असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट। आई हैविंग ए 10-year experience in teaching field and I also completed M.Tech in electrical power system. Hello friends, so in the last lecture we have to study the different problems regarding the design of DC machine. Today we have to take the next examples, and that example is a lengthy but it is a very simple problem. It should be take a more time, but you can easily understood that problem. So take the next problem. So next problem is, I read that problem. Find the main dimensions, comma, number of poles and length of air gap of a 1000 kilowatt 500 volt 300 rpm DC generator. Assume the specific magnetic loading is 0.7 Weber per meter square, comma, ampere conductor per meter, 40,000 square pole face, ratio of pole arc to pole pitch is 0.7. Assume efficiency as 92% and gap contraction factor adds 1.15. So just listen that problem. Before that problem we already calculate the or how the calculating the main dimensions and number of poles, that things we should be know. But in that problem there will be the one different parameter we have to be calculating. That parameter is length of air gap, that is the LG. So LG we have to going to calculate. But overall problem you should be listen carefully or read carefully. There will be the three factor we have to be calculating: main dimensions, number of poles and length of air gap. So this problem is a lengthy problem, but it is the very simple problem. Okay, so from that problem what data should be given? So first is given to P, that is the 1000 kilowatt. Next voltage is 500 volt, and that is the speed is 300 rpm. So speed is given in rpm, it should be convert in rps. So for that the speed is divided by 60, so it will be converted in rps. So divide that 60, we should be get, that is the 5 RPS. So speed is converted in RPS and that is the 5 RPS. Next you have to given B average, that is the 0.7 Weber per meter square, and AC is equal to 40,000, and they also given gap contraction factor, that is the 1.15. So it is the nothing but the kg. So this kg is the constant and that value is the 1.15. so according to the given data, how will be the calculate the value of main dimension, number of poles and length of air gap. So take the one by one. So first step is, so we already know that power developed by the armature is PA is equal to P divided by efficiency. So put the value, P is the 1000, efficiency is the 0.92. so calculate that value and it should be come 1087 kilowatt. So power developed by the armature, it should be 1087 kilowatt. So next we have to calculating PA is equal to C0 D square LN. So from that formula we have to calculating the main dimensions, that is the D square L. Okay, so already we have to be study that in the previous examples. So PA is equal to C0 D square LN. So put the value, P is nothing but 1087 is equal to pi square into B average 0.7, AC 40,000 into 10⁻³ D square L N. N is the speed in RPS and we already calculate that value, that is nothing but the 5. So put that value and calculate the D square L is equal to 0.78668. So call this equation number 1. So we have to be calculate or separate that D and L. So for that we have to calculating the number of poles. So when you calculating the number of poles, you should be considering the frequency. So from that frequency we have to be conclude that number of poles. So frequency is to be within a limits of 25 to 50 hertz. The choice of number of poles for this size of machine lies between 8, 10 and 12 poles. So in that machine the number of poles P should be lies in between, that is the 8 poles, 10 poles, 12 poles. So just calculate which poles should be suitable or which pole is conditions should be fulfilled. So take the number of poles. First is the P is equal to 8, then frequency is nothing but F is equal to PN divided by 2. Put the value, P is taken 8, N is the speed, it should be already calculated that 5 divided by 2, then frequency will get 20 hertz. So take next, P is equal to 10. So F is equal to Pn divided by 2. Put the value. So for the number of poles 10, the frequency is 25 hertz. So take next, P is equal to 12. Frequency is equal to Pn divided by 2. Put the value, then frequency is 30 hertz. So again, we have to check that the number of poles 8, the frequency is the 20 hertz. So it is not fulfill the conditions, but number of pole 10 and 12, the frequency is fulfill the conditions. But again, we have to be satisfy the some conditions like that current per brush R. So in that, neglecting the field current. So line current IA is equal to 1000 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 500 is equal to 200 ampere. So again, we have to check the conditions. So take the P is equal to 8. So when the P is taken 8, the how much will be the current per brush arm? So we have to calculate. So current per brush arm is equal to 2IA divided by P. Put the value 2 into, so line current IA is equal to 2000 ampere and pole is the 8. So it will be get 500 ampere. So it is for that P is equal to 8. So similarly for P is equal to 10. Current per brush R 2IA divided by P, put the value and it should be come 400 ampere. And similarly for P is equal to 12, the current per brush R is 2IA divided by P. Put the value 2 into 2000 divided by 12. So for the P is equal to 12, the current per brush R is 333 ampere. So 333 ampere. So we conclude that the current per brush R is limited to 400 ampere. Therefore, 8 pole cannot be used for this machine. Now the choice remains between the 10 or 12 poles. So when you calculating the current per brush arm, the current per brush arm is limited to 400 ampere. So above, only the number of poles 10 and number of poles 12 should be fulfill the conditions. So P is equal to 8 is not fulfill the conditions because the current is the 500 ampere and is about to the 400 ampere. So when you are taking the P is equal to 8, current will be the 500 ampere and it is about to the 400 ampere. So again, the choice remains between the 10 or 12 poles. So therefore, to take a choice between 10 or 12 poles, work out D and L for both the number of poles. So for that, first take P is equal to 10. P is equal to 10. So square pole face. So we already know that when the pole is the square face, then L divided by psi into tau is equal to 1 cross multiplied, then L is equal to psi into tau. L is equal to psi into, put the value of tau. So tau is the pole pitch and that value is the pi d divided by p. Put the value, psi is 0.7 pi d divided by p. So p we have taken here 10. So put that value. So will become L is equal to 0.22 d. Okay, so call this equation number 2. Now put the value of equation number 2 in the equation number 1. We get d square L is equal to 0.78668. So put the value of L, we already calculating that. So d square into 0.22d is equal to 0.78668. So calculate that d is equal to 1.53 meter. So that d value we have to put in the equation number 1. So we have to get the value of L. So L is equal to 0.22d. put the value of d. So calculate the value of L and that is nothing but 0.335 meter. So again calculate the pole pitch. So pole pitch is equal to pi d divided by p. Put that value and pole pitch should be come 0.48 meter. And next will be the armature ampere turn per pole. That is the ATA is equal to AC divided by 2 into pi d divided by p. So put that value. AC is equal to 40,000 divided by 2 into pi into, so d value we have to calculating, that is the 1.53 divided by 10. So 10 is the p value, that is the number of poles. It will become 9613. Okay, so just we have to be keep in mind that value should be come when we have to be taken p is equal to 10. P is equal to 10. Okay, so which value should be satisfy the conditions? Okay, now take the p is equal to 12. So same procedure, we have to calculate the values, all the values when p is equal to 12. So take the for square pole face, L divided by psi into tau is equal to 1 cross multiplied, L is equal to psi into tau, then L is equal to psi into pi d divided by p. Put the value and the L is equal to 0.1832 d. So call this equation number 3. Now put the value of equation number 3 in the equation number 1. we get the value of L. So d square L is equal to 0.78668. Put the value of L d square into 0.132 d is equal to 0.78668. Calculate, get the value of d, that is the 1.63 meter. Similarly, put the value of d in the equation number 3, we have to get the value of L, and that is the equal to, L is equal to 0.3 meter. Similarly, calculate the value, that is armature ampere turn per pole. So that is the ATA is equal to AC into tau divided by 2. Put the value of tau is the pi d divided by P. So put the value of AC is the 40,000 divided by 2 into pi into d value is the 1.63 divided by 12. So it should become 8534. Again satisfy the next condition, that is the pole pitch. So pole pitch is equal to pi d divided by p is equal to pi into 1.63 divided by 12. So it should become 0.4267 meter. So that value you have to be calculating when you are taking the p is equal to 10 and p is equal to 12. So now armature ampere turn per pole is within a limits of 10,000 for both the cases. So when you are considering the armature ampere turn per pole, so its value is the within a 10,000s. So in the both the cases, when we have to taking p is equal to 10 and p is equal to 12, so that value should be come within a limits. But when you are taking the pole pitch, okay, pole pitch, what will it happens? Pole pitch for 10 pole is within a limits of 0.45 to 0.55 meter. But for 12 pole, it is not falling in the limits. Is not following the limits, okay, because of the when you are taking the p is equal to 12, the pole pitch should be come 0.4267. so it is the below the limits, okay, because of the pole pitch value should be in between the 0.45 to 0.55 meter. So number of pole 10 is the satisfy the that conditions. So we have to be taking or select the number of pole is the 10. So we should be get the p is equal to 10. So again checking the that machine should be also satisfy the peripheral speed. So we should be know the peripheral speed is the va is equal to pi dn. So put the value pi into d is the 1.53, n is the speed in RPS, and that is the 5, put that, and it should be come 24 meter per second. So this is the within a permissible limits of 30 meter per seconds. So this machine is the peripheral speed within a limits. Okay, so from that above 2, when taking the P is equal to 10 or we are taking the P is equal to 12, we have to calculate the main dimensions, that is the D and L, and also we have to calculate the number of poles. So that is nothing but the P is equal to 10. Now we have to going to calculate the length of air gap. So length of air gap is the calculating that, for that maximum flux density in the gap BG is equal to B average divided by psi, put the value B average 0.7 divided by 0.7, it should become 1 Weber per meter square. Again, next MMF for air gap, that is the ATG is equal to 800000, that is the 5 times 0 into BG, KG, LG, put that value 8, 5 times 0 into BG value 1, KG value 1.15 into LG. So is equal to ATG is equal to 920000 LG. Call this equation number 4. Assuming that air gap MMF is equal to ATG is equal to 0.55 into armature ampere turn per pole, that is the ATA. So ATG is equal to 0.55 into ATA. So we have to already calculate the value of ATA. So take that value. So ATA, put that, and should be get the ATG is equal to 5287, that is the 5287. So put that value in the equation number 4, that is the ATG is equal to 920000 LG. Put the ATG value, that is the 5287 is equal to 920000 LG, and calculate the value of LG, and that is the equal to 5.75 mm. So in this fashion, in that fashion, we have to calculate the main dimension, number of poles, and LG. So that problem is the very lengthy problem, you should be take the time, but it is the very simple problem. So in the university question paper, you should be asked for the 6 marks, and it is the very important questions, or it is a very important examples. So please note that you should be understood that problem, you should be get the 100% mark, so that it should be remember that problem. So it is a lengthy, again you have to conclude that it is a lengthy problem, but it is the very simple problems. Okay, I hope that you have to be understood that problem. If you have any doubt, please ask me. Thank you very much.